Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to talk about manipulating formulas. Some that seem a little harder for students when they first look at them, they're really not that difficult. But they have some of these have subscripts in them. For some students, that throws them off a little bit. So these are the three examples I'm going to be doing in this video. For the first one, when we say it's to solve an equation for y, that means we want to isolate the y. So the first thing we're going to do is get rid of that fraction by multiplying both sides by 3. When I'm multiplying both sides of the equation by 3, when I have a parenthesis like this, I multiply outside of the parentheses, but not the terms inside the parentheses. That means that I'm going to get 3b over here, but over here, these 3s are going to cancel on the right side. And once they cancel, then I have an equation that no longer has a fraction in it. So I have 3b and then x, z plus y. Now I'm trying to solve for y, so the next thing I'm going to do is divide both sides by x, and that's going to get rid of the x over here. It's going to mean that there's going to be an x on the other side instead. So now I have 3b over x and then x over x. Notice that the x over x is going to cancel straight out. And then I also want you to notice that I could have in one step multiplied by 3 over x. And if I had done that, you can see I would get 3b over x, which is what I'm getting here. And over here you could see that the 3s would cancel and those x's would cancel. So it's okay to do that in one step. I did it in two because it's a little less confusing for people. And then you can see that I end up with 3b over x equals z plus y. Remember, we're still trying to isolate the y, so the last thing we need to do is subtract z from both sides. Once we do that, then we're going to have our minus z on both sides. This z minus z on the right is going to go away, and that's going to leave our final answer, which is I put y on the left side, but I have then 3b over x minus z. Remember, I can flip-flop sides as long as I change both sides and keep both sides exactly the same as I do that. For the second one, we're looking for r sub 1 to isolate the r sub 1 here. We're looking at this problem because people get confused when they see subscripts on the variables. It is just a way to identify that we have three different r's in this problem. R subscript 1, r subscript 2, and R subscript A, we usually just say R sub 1, R sub 2, R sub A. They behave as any other variable. So what we're going to do first is subtract the R2 off, the R sub 2, excuse me. And if you do that, then you're going to get rid of the R sub 2 on the right side and move it over to the left side. And finally, we just have to divide both sides of the equation by 3. And 3 on both sides, that means the 3 over 3 will cancel on the right side, and that's going to leave us with r sub 1, which is what we wanted. And on the right side, we have r sub a minus r sub 2 over 3. And of course, that was originally on the left side. Again, I'm just flipping those around when I'm finished. Finally, we have the third problem. This one is different because the variable in question shows up in two places. We want to solve for x sub 1. But that's not a problem because once we multiply both sides by x sub 1, you can see that it's going to cancel it off on this term on the left. It's going to cancel it off on the term on the right. And the only one that's going to be left is the 3 times x sub 1. And then we want to solve for x sub 1. So we want to get rid of the negative y over here or the minus y. So we're going to add y to both sides. And when you do that, you have p plus y, and then you have the minus y plus y, which are opposites, so they're going to go away. And then you have what's left is p plus y is 3x subscript 1. I want to isolate that x sub 1, so I'm going to divide both sides by 3. If I put them both over 3, you can see that the 3 over 3 cancels over here on the right, and then flipping that around, I have x sub 1 equals p plus y over 3. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.